People think the Greens are a one-issue party.
We're not. We stand for progressive social policies that make housing and education accessible.
We stand for ethics in government by telling the truth.
And creating an electoral system that makes your vote count.
In fact, we stand for the same things that most Canadians stand for.
And that is why we're running for the Green Party.
People also think we're a one-person party.
Not in this election.
Looking at here in terms of climate emergency can be boiled down to this. The science was always clear. That pulse of carbon into the atmosphere and what it would do to global climate systems was identified first in 1896. Burning fossil fuels to drive our economy was understood from the get-go to be a threat to climate stability. In other words, the world scientists have never doubted. It's like add salt to water, you get salt water. Add warming gases to the planet's atmosphere, you get a warming, destabilized planetary system. So we were warned. The hard reality for Canadians in this election is that getting it right is critical to our children's future, and we have one chance to get it right. Failure is easily within our grasp. Success is more difficult. We're facing really huge challenges. What do we do? The truth is that we're facing human extinction, and that's not something people want to hear. So I grew up with a mother and a father who believed that if you thought something was wrong, you had a duty, a moral responsibility to work to make it right. I was in grade 6 when we had lambs born. One of the mothers died with this incredibly scary nerve poisoning. It was heartbreaking. When I was 18, we had the Nova Scotia government decide to spray some of these pesticides on us. We began to find out that in New Brunswick, where they'd been doing the same thing, children were dying. So I had no real choice in the matter to be unbroken in my determination to be working for change, for the betterment of the world. Negotiating the Montreal Protocol to protect the ozone layer, stopping acid rain, working to create parks across Canada, particularly Guayahanas National Park in Haida Gwaii, stopping logging of forests that were over 1,000 years old, starting the work on climate change. I helped organize the first global scientific conference on climate change in June 1988. I mean, there were so many wonderful moments in working for the Minister of Environment in that era. In the last number of decades, the relative power of the nation state has declined relative to the power of transnational corporations. More than ever, we need to assert the power of democracies acting in the interests of survival. We have a choice. We have every opportunity to ensure that every citizen of this planet, every member of the human family is educated, has a roof over their head, has clean water, has adequate nutrition. It's our message now. And right now, being leader of the Green Party and leading a lot of Greens into Parliament so that we can do that together with other people and other parties is the best possible vehicle to pursue my calling. Hope is essential. We have a responsibility to ensure the young people of this country, right down to our babies and grandbabies, have a safe, secure future in Canada. This is all within our grasp. That drives me. And we need to have the kind of political leadership that gets people engaged.